Peter and Clay, you guys look lonely. Come over here. Come on. Okay, on the board, we've still got drunks on film and animated badasses, which nobody seems to like. Let's take a look at our new category. Horror movies. Who won the coin toss?
I did.
Clay, okay, that means you'll go first. Which would you like to eliminate?
I'm gonna whack horror movies.
Gonna whack horror movies. Peter, you may also eliminate a category.
Drunks on film.
Drunks on film, okay, so we're playing animated badasses. Mike Myers provided the voice for a big green ogre in what 2001 animated film?
I would have to say Shrek.
That is correct. Clay, you're holding the ticket for now, but Peter will steal it away if he can tell me this. In Toy Story, Zurg is the evil arch enemy of what space hero character voiced by Tim Allen?
Buzz Lightyear.
That is correct. Good play. Most people know that the villain in Aladdin was Jafar, but Jafar had a talking parrot sidekick named Iago. Who provided the bird's voice?
I'm gonna have to take a guess at this one. I'm gonna say Gilbert Gottfried.
That is correct. Grab a hold of that ticket. Hey, Peter. Listen up. In Yellow Submarine, the Beatles' Happy Pepperland was invaded by a bunch of villainous psychedelic creatures. What were those nasty creatures called?
The Blue Meanies.
That's correct. Grab a hold of that ticket. Okay. These are going to get a lot harder. Okay. It's sudden death. Got to get this one.
Okay.
What 1978 animated film ends with a visit from the Black Rabbit of Death?
Watership Down.
That is correct. Very impressive. Wow. Okay, Peter. I need to get this right. What was the X-rated animated movie based on the underground comics of R. Crumb, and who directed that movie?
The movie was Fritz the Cat. The director was Ralph Bakshi.
That is correct. Grab a hold of that ticket. Very impressive. Ready, Clay?
As ready as I'll ever be, Chris.
Get this one right. Now you want that ticket. There's a scene in Fantasia where a giant demon springs up from hell and does lots of nasty stuff. What piece of music is playing when that giant demon arrives?
It's a Tchaikovsky piece.
You know what? You got me on this one.
Night on Bald Mountain. Night on Bald Mountain.
Right.
That means, Peter, you're moving on to round two. You got real deep in the category. You should be really proud you made it this far, but you're not going home empty-handed. Here's your ticket home. Later, Clay. I promised you a brawl, and I think we delivered. At the end of the first cut, we've got Peter, Vince, and Jim. There are three now, but after this round, there will only be two. You've tested their knowledge, and some of these guys scare me. But now they're going to get a chance to back their movie knowledge up with a little attitude. It's time for the great debate. You guys are going to face off in head-to-head debates. The first two people to win a debate move on to round three. The last person gets a ticket home. To help us decide who wins each debate, we have three very special guests. She sucked blood in Blade and was Patty Hearst's daughter in Crybaby. It's the lovely Tracy Lords.
Hello, Chris.
How's it going? He was Shaft in the 70s, and he's still the baddest mother around. It's the legendary Richard Roundtree.
What's that, Chris?
All right.
He's the star of indie classics such as Chasing Amy and Dogma. It's Jason Mewes.
I thought I was the baddest mother around.
You each got a randomly selected ticket to round two. Please open them now. Those numbers are your orders for the debate. So Vince and Jim, you're up first. Come on over here. You each have 20 seconds to make your initial debate. 10 seconds to rebut. Pay close attention to these lights. Green means go, yellow 5 seconds, red stop. Okay, you guys understand? Now, before the show, we interviewed each of you and we found out that Vince thinks the Coen brothers are overrated. Whereas Jim loves the Coen brothers. Okay, Vince, you're up first. You ready?
Ready.
Go now.
Well, it's not that I think the Coen brothers are bad directors. I just don't think they're as great as everybody says. They have good technique. I think they're in the league of old directors like Preston Sturges and Billy Wilder, people who wrote great screenplays but didn't direct with much craftsmanship. They have technique, but they don't really put a lot of heart and passion to their films. But I enjoy the film movies nonetheless. So. Oh, and also...
Jim!
Oh, yes. Well, I don't like some of their more macabre movies, but I think they directed a trilogy, a masterpiece trilogy of comedy with Raising Arizona, The Big Lebowski, and Oh Brother, Where Art Thou?
Time. Just a second. Now, that might have been okay for high school debating. But this is for the ultimate film fanatic of the Mountain Region! This is for $5,000! And you've only got 10 seconds! So Vince, go now!
Okay, like I said, the Coen brothers are overrated because they are... Okay, first of all, they haven't made a good film since Fargo, and they probably won't make one ever as good ever again. And that's the way I feel.
Jim?
I think he did his own rebuttal when he said they were like Preston Sturges because they used those marginalized characters. Great comedy.
Okay, time. The last thing you want to do is leave seconds on the clock. You want to use that time. You know, it's not up to me. It's up to the panel. Tracy, you're asleep. I need you to wake up and tell me who you think won the debate.
They bored me senseless, absolutely senseless. But I think if I have to choose, I think Jim sucked a little less.
Okay. That's
crazy.
One half-hearted vote for Jim. That means, Vince, you need to win the next two to move on. Richard Roundtree, who do you think won?
I guess I'll have to go with Jim.
Jim! That means you're moving on to round three. Stand over here. Jason, who do you think won? Jason,
Jim.
Who do you think
Jim.
Won? Jim?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, Jim, clean sweep for you. Show me the debating.